The plant pictured here is Brassica oleracea. If you really want your mind to be blown, just prepare yourself. Because within this species is kale, cabbage, cauliflower, kohlrabi, collard greens, broccoli, and Brussels sprouts. All of those are just different cultivars of the same species, Brassica oleracea. Just ponder that for a moment while you look at this beautiful ornamental kale. This is one we usually use for show rather than eating, although technically you could eat it. So, how to identify something that has such a wide range of cultivars with obviously different appearances? Well, we'll start with the growth form. It does grow as a basal rosette of leaves. Now, sometimes it appears acaulescent. Sometimes you can actually see a distinctive stem, as in this picture. Usually gets 10 to 24 inches tall and 1 to 2 feet wide. So here's a picture of more kale. This is the type we usually eat as opposed to growing for show, although again, you could do both. Again, that low basal rosette of leaves, and another thing that you'll notice about Brassica oleracea, if you feel the leaves, they're very thick, fleshy leaves. That goes for all the different cultivar groups, and they have sort of a glaucous coating to them. So that's something that'll help you tell it from lettuce. Some cultivars of this species do look a bit like lettuce, but the leaves are typically thicker and more glaucous than lettuce leaves. I know you guys would never confuse Brassica oleracea with lettuce, but I may or may not have done that at a cookout when I put it on my burger. Just saying. It happens. So this picture shows you the stem and just how those leaves are attached. Again, it's a basal rosette. So you can see as the petioles attach to the stalk, they sort of alternate around the stem in a circle. And then you can see those buds lying on top of the petiole. Now, as you've probably already figured out, the leaves of this species are quite variable. They're variable in shape, in size, in leaf margin, in color, but typically you're going to have some sort of green and purple coloration in it, although sometimes it may have white, it may have red, it just depends on the cultivar. You could have entire margins, you could have undulate margins, crispate margins, lobed margins, really any type. But if you see that purple coloration in it, and this is a different kind of purple than what you saw with lettuce. Lettuce was more of a reddish purple. This is a very violet purple. That's a good clue that it may be Brassica oleracea, and again, it does have a glaucousness to it. So, to help you break it down a little bit, I'm not going to hold you responsible for the cultivar groups on the test, but I'm going to talk about them just to help you keep it straight in your mind. You'll remember we used this phrase, cultivar group, at the very beginning of the course. This is a group of cultivars that share similar characteristics. So the Acephala cultivar group is the group of Brassica oleracea species that includes kale and collard greens. So they've been bred for leaves, basically. Cabbage fits into the capitata group. So here's a cabbage. And here's a quite different looking cabbage. But again, they're bred for leaves, and these leaves are held in a fairly tight head on cabbage, as you would expect. Now, when you move away from breeding for large leaves, if you breed for example, swollen stems or roots instead, then you get something like our kohlrabi here, which belongs in the gongolodes group. Or the Brussels sprouts. Here we've bred for large axillary buds on the stem. So this is Brussels sprouts, which are the gemifera group. And then we have the cultivar groups where instead of focusing on leaves, we're focusing on flowers, because that's what you're eating when you eat broccoli. You're eating the floral head, the inflorescence. And you'll notice here the leaves are starting to look quite different. They're still thick. They're still glaucous. It's still Brassica oleracea. So broccoli belongs to the italica group. And then cauliflower, again, bred for the inflorescence, for the flowers, which is what you're eating. We have the botrytis group. So here we've got white cauliflower. But then you have this purple cauliflower. Really purple cauliflower. So that should give you some idea of the variety available in the species Brassica oleracea. Just remember the basal rosette of leaves that are thick and glaucous. Purple coloration is, especially a violet purple coloration, is prevalent in this species, and that should help you keep it straight. So Brassica oleracea, again, kale, cabbage, cauliflower, kohlrabi, collard greens, broccoli, and Brussels sprouts.